guys, welcome to my channel. So today's video is a recreation of video of none other than the gorgeous Hina Khan. She was wearing this look in Indian Tele Awards and she was looking ravishing. She posted these pictures on her Instagram account where she was wearing this purple smoky eye and she paired it with nude lipsticks. She kept everything so simple, yes, yet so stunning. So I decided to recreate that look and here it is. So if you wanted to know how I created this look, then please keep on watching. I'm starting with my primer. For that I'm using this e.l.f. poreless primer and I'm just priming my face. I quickly want to mention one thing. Hina's facial structure and mine, they're completely different. I'm not trying to convert myself in Hina Khan or I'm not trying to achieve her facial structure here. I'm just trying to recreate the makeup that she was wearing. So please keep that in mind. Now I'm taking this Maybelline Tattoo Studio Brow Pomade in black brown. If you look at her picture, her brows are pretty full and spot on, and I'm just going to achieve the same thing. For that I'm outlining my brows first, then I'll be filling it in using smaller strokes. I'm just combing my brows so that there is no excess product. I'm taking this Makeup Revolution concealer and I'm just carving out the borders of my brows so that they look well defined and well shaped. All the products and their shades will be mentioned in the description bar below, so please do check that out. Now I'm just blending the concealer with my finger slightly. I'm taking these two color characters from LA Girl. This is their yellow and orange character and I have mixed them together equally and I'm just applying it under my eyes because I have horrendous dark circle and I want a full glam look. I'm also applying it around my mouth because I have hyperpigmentation around my mouth and it will help to neutralize them completely. And also I'm applying it on the areas wherever I have acne spots and some dark spots, and I'm just blending everything out using a damp beauty sponge. So this video is a recreation video as well as it is a full coverage foundation routine at the same time. So I think this video is going to be really helpful for our beginners as well. And I'm taking this Maybelline Superstay foundation in 220 and I'm just buffing it in using a buffing brush from Real Techniques. This is again a full coverage foundation. Now I'm taking the same concealer and I'm just concealing as well as highlighting the high points of my face. That means I'm applying it underneath my eyes, on my eyelids, as well as on my chin and on my mouth, cupid bow, the bridge of my nose and the center of my forehead. It will give me that perfect highlighted face as well as it will cover up any darkness or dark circles, pigmentation, anything that I might have on my face. Again, if you look at her picture, she was looking flawless. I mean, her skin was really flawless. There was no darkness whatsoever. It was full coverage. So I'm just trying to achieve the same thing here. And I'm using this Varth & Dorys loose powder in 07 and I'm just setting my under eyes using the same damp beauty sponge. This is my most preferred way for setting my under eyes. Now with this powder puff, I'm just setting my entire face and as you can see, I'm just pressing the powder puff. I'm not dragging it at all because if you do so, you may move the cream products underneath. Now I'm going to bake my under eyes. For that I'm applying tons of loose powder underneath my eyes. It will help to catch any fallouts due to the eyeshadows as well as it will bake my under eyes and it will ensure that my foundation is not creasing. I'm taking this light brown color from my Makeup Revolution Visionary palette and I'm just applying it as my transition color. She was wearing a perfect purple smoky eye and I'm going to recreate the same thing here. I'm taking this bright purple shade from the same palette, and with this Wet n Wild flat eyeshadow brush, I'm just patting it in all over on my eyelids. Now I'm taking this dark brown shade from my Maybelline's The Nudes palette, and I'm just blending out the edges so that there is no harshness at all and there is a smooth gradation. Now if you look at her picture, though she was not wearing any eyeliner, but she was wearing something on her top eyelids. I think this is a black eyeshadow, and it was a smoked eyeliner kind of a look, and I'm trying to do the same. For that, I am applying the black eyeshadow from my Makeup Revolution, from my Maybelline palette, and taking the black eyeshadow, I'm just smudging it in on my top lash line. I'm taking this dark brown eyeshadow and I'm just applying it on my outer V with this e.l.f. brush. Her outer V area was pretty well defined, and I'm trying to achieve the same thing here. I'm just highlighting my brow bones and my inner corners. For that, I'm using my Wet n Wild Precious Petals highlighter. She was wearing a black kajal on her waterline, and I'm doing the same thing. For that, I'm using my Jordana Easy Liner in black. Now I'm just smoking out my lower lash line using the purple eyeshadow. Her lower lash line was pretty smoked out with purple eyeshadow as well. Now I'm just coating my top and bottom lashes with this Wet n Wild Mega Length Mascara. Now if you look at her picture, it is really hard to tell if she was wearing false eyelashes or not. Her lashes was looking so full yet so natural, as you can see, and I'm going to do the same. For that, I am using this Kiss eyelashes in this style Shy, which is perfect for this kind of look. These are so natural looking. And I'm just dusting off the excess powder, and here is the complete eye look. I'm truly happy the way it turned out. I think this eye look is pretty similar to hers. What do you guys think? Now I'm taking this Milani Silky Matte Bronzer in Suntan, and I'm just contouring the parameters of my face. If you look at her pictures, she had a very subtle contour on her face. Though I'm not sure if she was wearing a blush or not. Even if she was wearing a blush, it was so subtle. I mean, the color is so subtle and so glowy. And I'm going to do the same here. For that, I'm taking this Milani Baked Blush in Luminoso, and I'm just applying it on my cheeks. This gives me a very subtle color as well as some luminosity, because it is a shimmery blush. I won't say shimmery, but it has some shimmer particles, and it will give me a perfect glow because her face was literally glowing. It was not dewy, it was actually glowing. And to add more glow to my face, I'm using this Milani setting powder and 04 Radiant. Though it is a setting powder, but trust me guys, it is like a loose highlighter, and it will give you a perfect overall glow. I'm taking this Precious Petals highlighter from Wet n Wild, and I'm just highlighting the usual places that I normally highlight. Again, if you look at her picture, you can see that her face is glowing. So the highlight on her face is like spot on, and I'm just trying to achieve the same thing here. I'm taking this Wet n Wild Perfect Pout Gel Eyeliner in Bare to Comment, and first I'm just lining my lips, as well as I'm going to fill them up using the same lip liner. And now for my lipstick, this is I think Wet n Wild Megaless Lipstick in Bare It All, I believe. Yes, it is Bare It All, and I'm just applying it on my lips. If you look at her picture, her lips were not matte at all. It was glossy. To achieve that, again I'm using this Wet n Wild High Shine Liquid Lipstick in Cedar Letter. And I think this lip combo looks perfect. I'm just setting my entire makeup using this L'Oreal To Match Lumi Makeup Setting Spray. Again, this has some kind of shimmer particles in it and it gives you a perfect natural healthy glow. And my makeup is all done. And here is the complete look. I do not have similar outfits or similar jewelries in my collection, so I'm sorry for that. And please let me know your thoughts regarding this look. And if you enjoyed watching this video, then please give it a big thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. And if you are not following me on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter, please do follow me there. All the links will be given in the description bar below, so please do check that out. So see you soon in my next video. Till then, bye and take care.